Okay, so let's get started on some of the pages. Some of them are pretty straightforward, and some of them are just a little bit, have a little bit more to them. So I just figured that I would show you a little bit of both. That way you could see what one
There's
of the
different
this
sizes.
This is the 3x4 page, and this is the 4x6 page. So these can be used as pages. They can be used as inserts where you fold them in half and glue them together and go like that. I'm going to cut off these extra tabs and doodads and things. And let me show you what I mean. Get my score mat here. So again, I want to score at that score line just to give it a little help. Oh, and these, by the way, I double-sided printed. This is not laser printed. This was inkjet printed. I forgot to have them do that when I took it up to Staples to have them laser print it. So I just really quickly ran it through my printer over there. And the same thing for this page. I won't show you every page because some of them, like I said, are really, really, really straightforward. But I wanted you to see what I was talking about. The easiest way to cut these out. So score them. Move that out of the way. And then take it over to your paper trimmer. Line it up and cut them both at the same time. So you see it's a nice clean line. On the other side it's a nice clean line. And if it gets off a little bit, you just flip it over and trim it again. So you trim off all the edges, and then you take that same 1-inch round corner punch and you get all your corners. So you do all of them at the same time. So when you open up your page, it's got all the rounded corners. Let me show you on the small one. And try not to, if you purchase this from me, don't expect it to be perfectly straight with the edge of the paper when you go to cut these out. That's my printer. I literally just printed out something to use today. They're not always perfectly straight because I physically make these things and then I attach them to another piece of paper. So, it could be a little cattywomped, not the page, but in orientation to the page that it's attached to, it might be. So, this could be a page, or you can glue it all together and it's an insert. So, since I double-sided printed this one,
so
this
those
one
are the easy
page.
Ones.
You just cut them out, it's pretty straightforward, and then you ink all the edges, front and back. And then this page, this one is a pocket page. So what you do is you take your scissors, just like you did the front cover, and just trim along this edge. Well, my fingers are getting in the way. It's good to drink a lot of coffee when you're going to be doing these kind of pages. Because the crazier looking, the better. Okay. So this one probably didn't need to be printed double-sided, obviously. But so then what you're going to do is you're going to ink these edges really quickly, just like this. There's so much going on my desk. And then you're going to take the glue, the same fiber tack, and put it along the back side there, like that. And it should line up just perfect on the edge of this piece here. So you're gluing this piece onto the inside of the other page, like that. Okay, you let that dry. So then when we sew it into the book, we sew it in here and then we glue the edges down, and then that's a that's a pocket. Isn't that cool? This is one of my favorites. I really like it. All right, so there's one of the, what did I do with the other pages? One of the ones that I wanted to show you how to do that. And then there's some more pages. You just do the same thing, you trim. If you wanted to make, I have pages made already of those. So if I wanted to, I could trim it a different way, like this. See, I've already got it to where it's like this. And then it's a page. It's folded out. Is this one printed on the back? Yep. So then I think you can then trim it this way. So now we can glue this together and make a tag. Now normally I wouldn't print on the back side of a tag. But I'd already cut these this way. So I wanted to show you that you can use them two different ways. And see how that didn't trim very perfectly? I'm gonna do it with my thingy. I'm gonna try one more time. Nope. Well, let's see if ink covers it up. Yep, you can't really even tell now. So, all right, so there's another way to use those pages. I'm gonna put those aside. And then here's a pocket page. I'm going to go ahead and slice the bottom off here. Put that aside. I'm going to score it right down the middle. I hope you can see. I keep getting out of frame. I'm going to fold it. And I'm gonna, whoops, move that out of the way. Trim the edges. Then the next step would be to cut along this line right here to separate the two pieces. And then the other punch that I used when I was designing this was a 1-inch circle punch. This one is also EK. So if you use that for these little circle places, it's a lot easier. Of course, you can always just cut them out with scissors. That's easy too. Okay, so this one, what's cool about this, if you print it double-sided, you can leave this open and glue this down as the pocket. So you leave it open now for when you sew it in, and then you glue that together, and that makes a pocket. So you can leave this flap, or you can glue it down either way. So I've printed off two of these, so I'm going to do one of each. So that one's pretty simple. Where's the other half of that piece? Now this one is the same thing. Oh, there we go. It's a little mini file folder, and it's two pages that go inside this mini file folder, and I've already made one of those, but it's the same way. You cut it out the same way, you know, cut it, score it, fold it in half, trim all the edges, same with that. This one has been printed on this, but this has not. So here's it all put together. It's a real simple two-hole binding, and I just tied a knot. So there's the front of the file folder. There's the inside, and there's a page. And then I glued the center page together. And then there's another page. Isn't that cute? And then I just used a little paper clip. This would be cute tucked in somewhere. My camera shut off. But this would be cute tucked in a pocket somewhere, hidden little journaling. But I'm not gonna cut these out on camera. So you would cut them out and you'd fold them, ink them up, and then like two holes. Just run your thread through and tie a little knot, and you got a cute little book. Okay. Next one. This one, same thing. This has been printed double. You just trim it, score it, fold it, and trim all the edges. And then this one back here, this is a cute little pocket page. life would be a lot easier if I would undo that lap. So I'm not going to do this one because it's, you know, just score it, fold it, and trim it. So this one, same thing. We're going to score it at this, all these score fold marks. I think this paper, by the way, is 65-pound white cardstock. And so then you should be able to fold all the lines there. And then you don't want to cut this off yet, but you do want to trim each one of these edges. Okay, and then we're going to trim this off. Then we're going to do the same thing with the corner punch. Okay, and then this edge, take your scissors. You don't have to do this. You can cut it straight across if you... I've got friends that are a little OCD about it. They want everything perfectly straight and aligned. So they might have a hard time with this. Okay. So then, for this one, so then with this, you want to ink this edge. Like so. And then it's going to fold over and be attached there. So you want to go ahead and ink this a little bit. Just so it's not such a stark difference. Then you take your glue. And be sure to get these little spots right here. Those little rounded corners so that they don't come open on you. Or you don't lose something in one of them because of one of them. Alright, and then you just fold it up. Get rid of that excess glue. And then you want to ink it up all the way around the edges. I'm still using that same coffee archival Ranger ink. It's what I used when I designed it too, so it's going to match pretty darn good. Although that doesn't look very dark right there. Okay, so this is this pocket. So when you put it in your signature, you sew the center part there, and then, well, I guess you don't have to, you don't even have to sew it in if you don't want to. It could be an insert as well. But yeah, that's where it would be sewn in if you sewed it into your book, or this way. It has no up or down, right or wrong. So you got a little pocket to tuck in something, maybe like tucking in something like this. This little file folder, right? Isn't that be cute? This one, straightforward. Okay. File folders cut out pretty easy. This one has been printed on the back side too. So we'll skip that one. Both of these pages are straightforward. You just cut them out. You score them, fold them, cut them. And then here, this one is a tag insert, and it's for, I'm trying to, I've already made one. Let me see if I can find that one. Oh, come on. Is it in here? It's in here. It's for this, this envelope right here that we haven't made yet. But here it is right here. So it's a tag, but I would also like for it to be a page. So we're going to cut, let's cut some of these extra strips off. This one folds up, you know, cuts out really easy. And then all these little extra strips, you know, it's kind of like washi tape. That's why I put them on there. You could just use them just like you would washi tape. Okay. Sorry about the noise. Ooh, got the light there. same thing, score down the middle. I didn't probably have to do that many, but okay. This one has the purple background on the back, so you just fold that sucker in half like that. Trim off the one edge. You see how it's not even, I don't know if you can tell, but it's kind of woo-doo-doo, because the actual tag that I made was really thin and it was very flimsy. Okay, that cut out really good. Let's cut off this top piece. And then I'm going to use just my scissors to cut this slanted part here, the little thing that makes it a tag. Another punch that I used while designing this book, it's just a regular old office hole punch. So when it's folded over, it should line up pretty good. Oh, it's off a little bit, but that's okay. It's a page. So let me open it up and do it over here. That one's double whammied. But again, it's okay. Oh, and it looks too like I missed I must not have scored it very good because it didn't line up perfectly. That's okay. That's what I mean by you can't really mess it up. You just flip it over and trim it off. Alright, so when I make it a tag, I make sure that everything's perfectly nice and neat, because when it closes up, it'll be the same. So then, before you get done with this one, then you're going to do the wiggly wiggly. This doesn't have to be perfect. But what's nice about that is it gives it this really cool edge. I like it anyway. I like that vintage edge. Also, before I flip this over, I also use reinforcers. You buy them white and you just take an ink pad and just swipe over it until they're brown or whatever color you want them to be. And then I just kind of add them into the spots. Like, since I messed that hole up, I bet you if I put one of these over top of it over here, I bet you nobody will even notice. Like that. So these are good to have. Since we're using that just standard office hole punch, these work, fit it perfectly. Now, the crocodile punch, it's smaller. Even the bigger hole is smaller. So, and you can see that didn't trim out very well. Let's see if we can just cover that with ink. So you can't even, doesn't even matter if you didn't trim it out super perfect. Okay, so, whoops, holding it out too far. So there's the, forgot a part. So that could be the inside or the outside, either way. It doesn't matter, whichever way you wanna. And then there's the other side. So it's a tag for the long envelope pocket. And it's also a page. So I printed two of these out as well, obviously, one for a tag and one for a page. And here is that envelope that I showed you that I put in the front cover. But what I wanted to do was, I wanted to make it a page too. So I'm going to make another one. And then here is the letter that goes inside of it. It's really, really cute, but I've made one already out of cardstock, and when you fold it up, it's really thick and it's really, really hard. So I just really quickly printed one on my printer out of just regular copy paper. So I'm gonna do that one and put it in an envelope instead of the big thick one. So maybe I'll use that as a page instead, the big thick one. Let me close my ink up. I've got so much stuff. I wish I could pan the camera, but oh, me and the camera had a fight before we got started here. It was not cooperating. Okay, let me cut this little piece off right there. That piece, it's optional, obviously. Where'd that envelope go? I have it on the back side of the little envelope. Just to write, to put whoever's name or whatever on there. It's optional. You can put it inside as a tag or whatever. But you cut that out The same way with the scissors, you know, just be all ragged and jagged and, you know, drink a lot of coffee. So you just do that for all four sides, and the same hoe punch, the office hoe punch works on that. I better not put that too far. Okay, this one, you also use the 1-inch circle punch to punch out that half a circle there. And then you just trim around. This one's kind of straightforward. Now you don't, since this is going to be a page, you don't want to glue it shut yet, because then you won't be able to sew it into your page. But I will go ahead and ink it all. Okay, so this one is ready to get sewn in. Oh, not yet. No, it's not. Gotta add that a little bit. And so when it gets sewn in, it'll be sewn in here. And then it'll be glued together like that. And then it'll have a flap. Cute, yeah. Alright. Now, let's do this. The letter that goes inside the front cover one. I guess it could go inside the one that's going to be a page too. So same thing, you just want to trim the envelope off there, score it. You got to be gentle with it. If you're going to use the paper, you got to be careful not to rip it. Fold it in half. You know what I'm going to do before I start trimming this? I think I'm going to go ahead and glue it together. That way I don't have to be so careful where my glue goes. I'm just going to make sure it's covered pretty good with glue here. Probably could have used a glue stick instead of that big thick fiber tack. Press it really, really good. Okay, now I'm going to trim off the end just like that. I'm gonna flip it over and trim this end just a little more. One more try. All right, now I'm gonna do this jagged edge over here, same way. The reason I like to go ahead and glue it before I do that trimming for something like this is it keeps it more stable. All right, now I'm gonna score these marks here. And what's really interesting about this little letter is some of you it may look familiar, because I had made them for I handwrite letters to my customers who order stuff from me. And I had used old book pages, and I distressed it, and I put some ink on it, and I just decorated it up a little bit. And then I would handwrite, you know, a thank you note. Well, I was shipping out my last journal, the art journal one. I was shipping that out, and this was my last one that I had made for just those art journals. So I was like, oh, that would be cute that'd be cute with my printable. So I scanned it really quick before I started writing to her, and I thought that'd be perfect. And that's where I came up with this little envelope, because I had to make it to fit, of course, to fit the letter. And it does. It's perfect. Okay. Anyways, just thought you might like to know where the idea came from. So now I'm going to open it back up. And I'm going to ink it. See, it's so cute. I just love it. When you close it up, it makes it a little hard. Isn't that cute? Okay, let me show you the other one that's made out of cardstock just real quick. this one, it's really thick and it's good. It's okay. It just, I really had to work with it to get it to lie flat. Can you see the difference in thickness? Yeah, it's just, it's a little bit easier. So, just thought I'd show you that. Just
sure,
all I did was I took some crochet thread to make it have a closure there. And it fits in there just nice, just like that. And there's your little hidden. So one of the strings goes one way, and then, no, one of them goes the other way, and then you just tie a bow. Yeah, that's easier said than done sometimes. And where's my cover? I'll go ahead and stick it in there so I don't lose it. See, just like that. Isn't that cute? Of course, I'm not finished with the cover, but that's a good start. I just really, really dig it. There we go. I just think it's adorable to have a pocket in the cover.
Okay. Here's a tag.
Moving on. Oops. There's a tag
for one of the pockets.
So this pocket here that I showed you how to do already, this is the tag that goes in this pocket. So this one, I've already made one, and so it's a double-sided tag. Cute, right? And it goes into the pocket like that. So I'm also going to make one as a page. This one is also an insert, a tag for one of the pages. I've already made the tag. Looks like this, double-sided. And I'm going to show you how I did this one because it looks like it would be really complicated, but it's not. And then this adorable, we'll talk about that in just a minute. Let me get this. Okay. So this one, you do the same thing. You score that center. Fold mark there. Now when I made the tag, I glued it. After I folded it and then glued it and then trimmed it because it's a lot easier. But since this is going to be two tags or a page, depending on my mood, I'm not going to glue it. So I'm just going to trim it just like I did everything else. Ah, look at there. I shifted it. Oh, I took the bottom off. No, it's okay. We'll just shorten her up here. Took her clear off. Okay, and then you take the corner rounder. See, even if you mess up like that, it doesn't matter. It was just like a quarter of an inch. All right, and so when you got it folded together, you take your little scissors and do a little bit of fussy cutting. You may want to take your time. But see how it cuts them both out at the same time? Makes it so much nicer. Okay. So, you know, ink all the edges. And this can either be a page or it could be a tag insert thing that's not closed that opens up. So you ink all your edges on that. And then these are tags and pages. Here are the insert tags. I messed up when I made these. They're already glued, so I can't go back. But my intention was these two would fold together and make a double-sided tag, so it wouldn't be the same color on each side. And then this way, if you cut it this way, it's a page. So I cut it that way and then glued them together. For the tags, so now you know my boo-boo. Same thing, you cut this one in half, You don't want to score it and then cut this one in half. You might get a little cattywonk. But score it, fold it, trim it, just like all the other ones. Easy, easy. Oh, I skipped one. Huh? This little guy turns into this. And is it not adorable? Oh no, I can't get it open. Oh, did I glue it shut? I might have glued it shut. Give me something. I don't know why I tucked it in like this. I hadn't tucked it in before. There we go. I think I glued it shut. Don't do that. Don't glue it. And so inside this cute little envelope, I put a little paper clip there. It's that nice little folded up note. Adorable. So I think this one might be a little self-explanatory with the folded up note part. You might want to print this out on regular paper too to fold easier. But you just go jaggedy, jaggedy, jaggedy. Those you're not going to match when you fold them up. It's just all random. And then cut this out. Score it. Fold it and glue it. And you got this cute little hidey spot for some journaling or a little letter or a little note to somebody. Okay. Here is a pocket page. Let me show you the pocket page because I'm going to do it differently this time. So the way this was designed, I can't even get the whole thing in the frame, is that it's a page. Oh, hang on. I'm going to have to come back. I got to change my battery. So this one was designed to, for these pieces to fold up and make a pocket. So I glued each end, and this piece, I wasn't going to glue this pocket at all. I was just going to use this to close it, but stuff gets wiggled around and stuff, and I don't know, I don't like it. So, but that's what this is for. But it could also be used as, inserts and tags and little extra journaling spots and stuff like that. Let's see how it's got that really cool little ragged edge right there. But I'm going to show you how I cut that out, but then I'm going to do something different with it. Well, that was a little strange. My camera just made a weird picture. Huh. Alrighty. Well, we'll just keep moving, and if my camera stops, well, I'll stop. I'm going to cut this bottom piece off. Okay, so we want to score it. I think y'all got the gist of the scoring part. I kind of cut it in just a little bit, so you want to just kind of trim that off with your scissors. Fold these pieces up like so. Then you can fold it in half and you can get all those corners at one time. See how nice and clean that makes it look? So you both bottom corners like that. And now everything's got that rounded edge on it. And then these pieces, once again, they're just ragged. Need some coffee again. Or have some sugar. So you do that to both pieces. So when you fold it up, you glue it, and you have these nice little, oops, wrong way, nice little pocket pages. Well, what I'm gonna do a little different with this one. I've already made one of those, so I'm gonna use this page in a different way. I'm gonna cut those pieces off, and I'm gonna hang on to them. I'm gonna use them for something else, just not on this page. So what I wanna do is I want to make this into a pocket page. So there's nothing, you know, there's no flaps, no nothing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rip it, but I'm trying to think of which way I want to rip it. I'm going to rip it this way, and it doesn't bother me if it's ragged, crazy ragged. Obviously it's going to be ragged. So when I glue it together, it's going to look like that. So that'll be another pocket page for for a tag or something to sit into, or photos or notes or whatever. But you want to ink all the edges, you know, ink that edge, ink, you know, all that, all the way around. And don't glue it, because we have to sew it in, since this is the Coptic Stitch one, so we have to be careful not to sew stuff together. Okay, aha, here's that long pocket. It looks like it's hard to cut out, but it's not. I'm going to cut this piece off first. And then I'm going to trim this piece off. Did I already tell you I love my trimmer? This thing is awesome. Okay. I'm going to take my corners. I'm going to show you real quick what I did with this. I mean, go off camera real fast, get all these pieces. I'm going to take my pre-med distress tool, and I'm just going to go along the edges like this. And then I've got a nice distressed edge to go. And this piece goes on the flap right there. I'm going to set that aside for just a second. All right, now I'm going to go and I'm going to trim all of the straight lines that I can. Most of these you don't have to be precise, because they're just the tabs that hold it all together. Whoa. Okay, I'm going to use my scissors here, and I'm going to cut this straight line, since I can't really get to it, and I'm going to cut it all the way up into that spot right there. Can't think of what it's called at the moment. I'll do that on every spot that I see like that. I'm going to make two little notches. Then I'm going to start folding all these edges here. It should work out to where if you cut it pretty good and folded it pretty good, you should be able to fold it up like that and get the corners all at the same time, just like the other one. Yep, pretty good. And then I'm going to fold this top flap down. Something's not wanting to jive here. What do we got going on? I didn't trim it just perfect, but I am now. Okay. Fold that down, you stick it in there. Okay, and be sure to get these little top edges too. Just like that. So now all your edges are covered. Okay. Your edges aren't covered. That's not what I meant. All the edges are cut. Okay, I also wanted to show you how I've been doing the closures. I have another, hit this one. On this page, I put these circles here. These I used over top of magnets, and these I used with brads to use a string to, like, you know, go looping around. So I think with this one, I'm going to use the magnet maybe, because I used the last one I made. And then now I don't know where I stuck it. I used the loopy loop. Here we go. So this one just has the loop. Although I didn't loop it around, I used these Tim Holtz. I don't even know what they're called. I'll have to figure out what they're called. And tied seam binding to it, and then I'm just tying those together. I thought that was a really cute little look.
Okay.
Well, let me show you how I used the I think I'm only going to need one circle. Here's another one. This circle is a circle punch. It's an 1¼ inch circle punch. That's what I used when I designed it. Sorry about the glare. It says 1¼ inch. This one is a paper shaper. That's all from EK. Success. So you line it up. It should be just perfect. Pop it out. All right, that's the next one. So let me put that back. And so since a magnet has just a little bit of depth to it, I like to take a foam pad and something and just kind of, not that, I've got so much stuff. Okay, here we go. A rounded end of something, and I just kind of like to work the paper just a little bit, just to kind of give it, get it some give, so that the magnet, when it's so that the magnet doesn't fight it so bad. It just gives it just a little bit of bow. And all I'm gonna do is find my magnets. I don't need that anymore. And I'm going to use a glue dot. Just a little, let me get two. Just little mini glue dots. I'm gonna stick my magnet. Doesn't matter which side at this point. Stick my magnet on there. And I'm gonna stick it in the middle. Hopefully in the middle. Like that. Oh, you know what? I don't need this. I only need you to do that if I'm going to put it on the inside of this little flap. But if I can find that piece I just cut right here, I'm going to put it underneath that, I think. Yes, that's what I'm going to do. Oh, goodness. All right, let's put a little give in this one. I've made so many different ways. I've made these books so many different ways. I'm starting to confuse myself. Okay. Give me that back. So I didn't need that. Well, maybe I'll leave it there for another piece. I'm going to get another glue dot. Same process though. I'm going to stick this in the middle. You don't have to use magnets. You can use whatever favorite closure you have, but this is one of my favorite. Oh, before I do that, before I put it down, I better ink it real quick. Okay. And then I'm going to put some glue. Run some glue all along here. And we're just going to eyeball it, centered eyeball it. I think it's funny. I've said many times I make up my own English. I think it's funny that when I designed this paper, I used old book pages. That is an English book, an old English book. I need to read it before I started tearing it up. It was just funny. All right, let's see. So then I'm going to take the other side. That was a positive. I'm going to take the negative part of the magnet. And I'm going to figure out which way. Okay. It's the piece that doesn't have the paper sticker on it is what it needs to. That's the part that needs to have. Well, since it's stuck to it like that, it's going to be underneath here. So I need the glue dot to be on that part of it. And the way I do this, it's probably not the best way, but it's my way. So I just set it underneath there and then close the top. And it should, yeah, it grabbed onto it. So now I'm just gonna press like that. Oh, and look, you can see it just a little bit sticking up, but that's okay. It still looks cute. Okay, let's see. This is not an insert. This is a page. So, what I don't want to close it up just yet, but I do want to ink it all up. And then on the back side of it is this piece here. So you cut it out and you glue it on the back side like that. Looks like a Polaroid or something. It's kind of cool. So anyway, so you just ink. You cut it up real jagged, just like, you know, everything else. And it's another little spot to add some journaling. So you do that, you put that there. Don't close it up yet though, because we need to sew it in still. So I'm gonna do that when the camera is not rolling. And we're gonna move on to the next page. The envelope. This is one of my favorites. I've already got one made. This here is that envelope. And where this is going is this one that I've already made. Where it's going is the inside cover. Just like that. And it's got a magnet in it. But that's to hold all the extra little bits that you cut off or whatever. So that's going there. But I wanted to make another one for a page. So, and there's some tabs and another strip of paper, just like washi tape. Oh, I cut that side. I need to be more careful. Okay, I wanted to show you how to do this one. It looks intimidating again, but it's not. You just cut the edges off, the straight edges, all the straight edges. Go ahead and pre-score all those fold marks. I've been working on these, this little mini book, and my first digital mini book, and I have been working on it, it seems like, for months. And that's why I haven't been on YouTube, is I've been working on this, trying to get it right, and I decided that I wanted to make it several different ways so that you can see the different bindings and stuff. And boy, oh boy, I've just been so busy. It's been so much fun though. Okay, that's not gonna matter. Yes, it will. So now this one's gonna be a page. So I'm gonna ink everything up. I'm not gonna stick it down. You've seen me make other books to where I folded the actual flap down and paper clipped it. And then when I sew it in, then I like, you know, and then I glue it down. So this is going to be a page. So I'm going to ink everything up and then leave it open. Library pockets. This one's fun. I wish that I could get everything in the frame. This is a library pocket. Oh, I can't even turn it around. Oh, there we go. This is a library pocket. I'm going to show you how to cut this one out too. First, this is the insert that goes in the library pocket. Let me show you the one I already made. It looks like this. Move this out of the way. This one is going to